opens a transparent trading room, cutting EU red tape. Europe needs reform.
Hello everybody and welcome to my video blog from Strasbourg for the second session in October. You'll notice that we've had two this month. That makes up for not having one in August, so that we're in compliance with the treaties. We've discussed this before, we just have to put up with this. I'm going to rather exceptionally just talk about one issue today, partly because I think it will give you a little bit of an insight into the life of an MEP, because whilst I talk to you every month about the various issues in which we're dealing, some of those I deal with directly, some of those less directly, I rarely talk about the bulk of the work that I do, because clearly coming here to Strasbourg once a month is just a snapshot. And for the last 2 years, I've been working as the rapporteur, that means the Parliament's lead member, on air quality regulation. This is really important. 400,000 people die a premature death in the EU from poor air quality every year. Tens of billions are spent on lost work days because of respiratory disease, and also on Medicare, on bills, health bills, which for the UK is of course very important because that's our NHS. And we really need to do something about cleaning up our air. And for those of you who might say, well, yes, okay, we can do that, but what's that got to do with Europe? I think it's important just to stress that 40% of the air that we breathe in the UK, particularly us in the southwest, actually comes from Europe. It's not what we're producing ourselves, it's from other member states. So it's vitally important that this is a cooperative attempt, a cooperative effort by all member states to make sure that we reduce the health impacts of poor air. And I'm the rapporteur. I've been working on this, as I say, for 2 years. It's taken a lot of my time. There's a lot of process to go through. People often say, why does European legislation take so long? Because we have so many checks and balances, and because we deal with three institutions, the Commission's report, the Parliament's review, which is what I've been doing, and the amendments, and then of course we go into a negotiation with the Council, which is the Member States. And we're just at that point, 2 years on, where we're about to vote this afternoon on my report. So most of my week this week has been spent running around doing amendments, talking to colleagues, very excited, and I'm hoping that we're going to get a really good report both for the UK and for the rest of Europe, so that we can really get on with dealing with the air quality problems that we have. So I look forward to talking to you again next month with the results of that. Look out for emails from me letting you know how we get on. And for those of you who are concerned about car emissions, and who isn't these days following the revelations around VW, we hope to have some resolutions from Europe on that problem within the next month. So, thank you very much. I look forward to speaking to you again in November.